Hello and welcome back. It is a super cool show. Apparently tonight we are like, whoa, not only taking it a little bit lower key, but we're also screwing up the green screen. It's okay, we fixed it. It's all good. I'm chilling out with Super Kale and she's going to be heading out this part, but say hello.
Hello.
And we're going to talk about Christmas because we're just like going through, we're rifling through the holidays. So what were some of your favorite Christmas traditions? And slash, how do you do Christmas? Like unwrapping of presents and all that kind of stuff.
Well, we wait till midnight and then we open all of them. And then we get Santa's presents the next day.
Dude, Christmas twice.
Yeah, it's nice. We don't leave cookies for him or anything.
Oh, dude, when I was like probably 8 or 9 years old, I was the smartest kid in the world. I was out to prove that Santa existed. You ready for this story? Okay.
Yeah.
I'm not ready for the boss, apparently. I left out 3 Oreos for Santa and instructions. Okay? Get this. I was like, Santa, with the first Oreo, I want you to eat the whole Oreo. With the second one, I want you to eat only the frosting. And then the third one, I want you to eat one bite. But you have to dip it in the milk. Please do not drink all of the milk. I'd like to see that you actually dipped the third Oreo in the milk. I was on that like a hawk.
Dang.
Santa was like up to the test. And I'm telling you what, he totally came through. Left a little bit of the milk behind. Had some of the chocolate residue in it. Ate the first one. Ate the cream, the frosting, whatever, out of the second one. Like, did exactly what I asked. It was so baller. Never have I felt so cool and, like, I believed in Santa so strongly.
That's awesome.
So, there you go. Inquisitive kids of the world. Santa definitely exists, and he knows how to read.
Face roll!
Yes, is he like Z, Q, X, D, F? Face roll! How's it going? Welcome to the show.
Super cool. He's smiling face.
Oh, jeez. What's going on? I love that like every single time you come in, you give me a big old shout out. I really appreciate that. Hang on a second. Kaylin, I'm going to share screens with you really quick just so that the flickering goes away because that seems to... What is it about the... I don't even understand. I don't get it. I'm just glad that it fixes the problem. You're like CSI on Santa. Dude, the next CSI Christmas special that airs, like, I'm going to be the star. I am the protagonist. I be tagging the pros. Woo!
That probably seems so random to face roll. Because he just got here. You're like CSI on Santa.
Face roll, just so that you didn't miss out, I freaking gave Santa some very specific cookie eating instructions 1 year just to prove that he existed.
Whoa! Guess who's here?
Dude, is it Ars Nation?
Yes.
Holy caboli camoli.
Santa himself.
Santa himself. Dude, if I had to ask for one thing for Christmas, it would be Ars Nation to come and hang out with me.
Aww.
That's right, feel special. And desired. Wow, I can't believe that you're here. Hi.
Yeah.
I'm like taken aback. Like, I don't see you often enough, brother man. This is Ares Nation is my best friend in the whole wide world. He's going to be the best man in my wedding. He's going to be the godfather of my children. Who's the demon chick? The demon chick's name is Azurul, and she's the boss. She's flying around nonchalantly, and I'm just, like, trying my best to live. Oh, that was bad. Hi! Daw! Yo, I've been playing Gnar on League recently. Dude, I don't know anything about Gnar. He came out, like, post me playing League seriously. I stopped keeping up with champs after, like, I don't know. Who was the last champ? Lucian, I think.
Yeah, me too.
And then I just, like, put it away for a good long while. Played StarCraft. Things like that. Okay, sorry. Interrupted. So Santa, what actually brought up my thought about that story about Santa? Ow. Ow. Get your bony fingers out of my face. Do you remember?
Christmas?
Okay. Christmas? But, like, it must have been something specifically about Santa. Oh. Itchy eye problems.
Oh, opening presents from Santa.
Oh, opening presents from Santa. That's right. So, okay, so you opened up all of your gifts the second midnight struck, and then you got presents from Santa in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Were there any... Did you, like, have Christmas morning breakfast or, like...
Yeah. Can't friggin' not have breakfast. I had amazing breakfast, too. Well, what is amazing to me, anyways?
Yeah? So what is amazing to you, my dearest sweet thing?
I love me a ton of bagels, girl.
A ton of bagels, girl. You heard it here first.
Girl. You don't even know. We do bagels with, like, different kinds of cream cheese. Like, all... Like, we do, like, everything. Onion and, like, plain or something.
So would you go out and, like, buy the bagels from your local bagelry?
Yes, my favorite bagelry.
Gotcha.
This golden bagel. It's, like, right near our house. It's awesome.
And it's super delicious. Been there, can attest to its deliciousness.
Yeah. And then we get different kinds of cheese, and then we get, like, we do sliced onion, like, really thinly sliced red onion.
Ooh. I don't like onion, but ooh.
Ha! Tomato. Capers and bacon. So delicious. And we just had those, like, all morning, and coffee. And I feel like I remember one time we had latkes as well.
Oh, nice. Wow.
Yeah, we got a little bit of Jewish in our family.
A little bit of Jewish. Oh, gosh. Since when do you have the ability to turn into a red demon mouthy thing? Or mouth thingy, rather. I just got it. That's the ability of this area, this final area. Lox. Yum. It's been classified as the community's as space meatball.
Lox.
Yes. Now, did you do, like, fish on your stuff as well?
Yeah. I got it,
so
Josh, between bacon and fish.
Yum. Oh, I just don't even care. That sounds delicious. Ho! Platform disappearing on me.
That's as delicious.
Oop, that's okay, because I've got brownies waiting for me. Okay, so you ready for this? This is how my family does Christmas. Every Christmas Eve, we would receive Christmas pajamas. It was always like, you can open up one present on Christmas Eve, but your mom has to pick it out. So we were always, like, super excited, like, oh yeah, mom, pick a good one. And she'd grab, like, be this big old box, and you'd open it, and it'd always be Christmas jammies. And you know what? Cool, you know, for us enough, like, we never hated that it was Christmas jammies, you know?
Yeah, you're never like, mom!
Like, I wanted a toy. Like, why didn't you open up a toy? We were like, heck yes!
Things.
Christmas jammies! And, like, eventually you catch on, and you're like, oh god, what is this present that we have here on Christmas Eve? We never open up anything on Christmas Eve. Like, what is it? Oh! My mom would be like, I don't know, here's the box, why don't you open it? And it was Christmas jammies. Always Christmas jammies. I'm actually wearing a pair of Christmas jammies right now. Yeah, for those of you who thought I was wearing no pants. Pah! I'm wearing Christmas jammies. Come on. That's gross. So we would open that one present. I'm like, what was I talking about again? This happens with my brain when I'm doing things that require lots of concentration. And then Christmas morning, we would open up all the gifts from family and friends and all that kind of stuff. And Santa. And Santa would bring presents. I think Santa still brings presents. Despite my age, and relative knowledge of the existence of Santa, who clearly exists because he passed the Oreo test. The great Oreo test of 1990-something. I'm not going to give away my age. You kidding me? Who do you think I am? KY Gima? So this is the final boss. This is not the final boss. Or at least I don't think it's the final boss. I would assume it's not the final boss because the big old demon that you wake up at the very beginning of the game, his name is Jaul. And this is Azurul. And we haven't actually faced Jaul yet. So I'm assuming this is not the last boss. Can I say? No, I you can say. I'm like 100% positive. My guess is here. Okay, so just for the folks that have been here a while and have been watching this, here is my thought. This is what I think the rest of the game will be. I think I will fight this boss. There will be a short puzzle jumping thing. I will have to fight Jaul, and then just when I think the game is over, because Solgrin is Solgrin, I'll have to fight a second version of Jaul who's like more powerful or something, and I think that they're gonna call him Ultimate Jaul. Those are my theories. Don't tell me if I'm right or wrong. Don't tell me if I'm close or not close. But those are my theories. You can sit in your seat, laugh, squiggle, enjoy my coming pain. So why do those sound like Thug Nasty names? Dude, they are Thug Nasty. So here, just to finish up my story about Christmas so that Super Kalen can get off and get going. We would open up things, and then for breakfast, we would have my mom's delicious, homemade, from-scratch waffles.
They are delicious. I can attest to that.
Oh. So, anyways, that is how Christmas works in the Henderson, my parents' household. Up until the point where I left for college. That was pretty much how it always went. So now we're, Kaylin and I, going to be starting a family. I mean, you know, in our marriage, we're going to be starting a family. No grandkids yet. Don't mean to panic anyone, KY Gima.
She'd probably just, like, shrug her shoulders and be like, oh.
Fine, don't give me grandkids then.
Hi, Eris Nation. How's it going? How you doing, girl?
There are so many reasons that I love my fiancé. Oh, I'm so glad that I saved one of those.
I think that both of our friends are both of our best friends are like conspiring with each other, because my best friend just texted me today.
Yeah? Dude, my best friend and I have been texting like for the last couple of days.
What does it even mean?
What does it even mean? I never get to talk to this guy. It's because he's on break. My best friend is going through medical school, so he's just... He's a busy bee all the time. So when I get time with him, it's like muy preciosa. I never get time with him. Dude, Eris Nation, if you're down, I've got Skype open. If you are available to Skype and talk and chill out, I still have like another hour of gaming to do until I close out the show for tonight. If you want to be my front brain again for this boss, that would be most welcome, I'm sure. Think about it. Let me know.
I'm doing, girl. Enjoying the vacay that's turning out to be much more busy than school. Oh no! It's just because you're so popular. Hey, how's it going, Shark? Popping in before I sleep, he says.
Oh, hey, what's going on, Shark? Welcome, welcome!
He said, I love a man that can speak Spanish, lol.
That was Eris Nation that said that?
Yeah, that was Eris Nation. Not Shark.
That's too funny.
We cannot confirm for Shark that he loves a man who can speak Spanish.
But Shark, tell me truly. Tell me surely. Oh, man. Oh, this is tough. This boss is so hard. Yes, let's do it. Let me put away my gig clothes and stuff. Why you no raid? Because I'm facing Azurul, and he knows that I'm just going to be failing for the rest of the evening. So, anyways, before I go into the boss again, let me let you go. Thank you so much, Super Kaylin for hanging out with us tonight.
Yeah, you kicking me off, girl?
No, you can stay if you want. I just knew that you were saying you had places to go.
I don't know how, like, places are, though, per se, but I just know that my roomie is getting off. Soon.
Have fun, face roll. Play lots of League. You can leave me running in the background.
If you have them fancy computers.
Yeah, if you have a fancy computer or the bandwidth to do so. So hey, if you don't have to go, you don't have to leave. I am not kicking you off. I enjoy talking to you. Grr.
We can have Fez Nation on here too, right?
Yeah, you can totally add him. If and when he jumps on Skypeu. What other holidays are there? Holy crap. Since we're just like on the topic, we talked about Easter. What else, like the 4th of July? What are your 4th of July? I've actually got a couple of 4th of July traditions that always went down in the Henderson household. That was the worst run of that boss I have done yet.
We would just hang out at Botron's, and my uncle, who is an amazing cook, would barbecue.
Oh, yeah, you're talking about your Uncle Jason?
Yeah.
Oh, what a baller. That guy got, what is it, a smoker?
Yeah.
For Christmas or something, or for his birthday. And he has made some of the most delicious looking stuff. I haven't gotten to try it because I've been in Arizona. But I keep seeing him post pictures on Facebook, and I'm like, oh, nom nom. Nom nomicon. No, come back! Oh, now you come back. You sucker of a platform. Blur. New Year's. Oh, yeah, we'll have to talk about New Year's, too. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my New Year's is complicated.
Yeah, my New Year's is really simple. It's like, stay up until midnight, watch the ball drop, go to bed. Like, maybe drink some champagne, but the drinking of the champagne is a recent thing, and it's only with my mom. So, like,
yeah,
it's not even that cool. I mean, it's, you know what I mean. It's not even that cool. Drinking with your mom is not even that cool.
Insert foots into mouth.
I have several foots to put in my mouth.
What holiday were we on? Oh.
We were talking about 4th of July, but we can talk about
4th of July. Yeah, we were just barbecue. One year we spent it in Washington, D.C., so that was really cool.
That's awesome! Oh, I'm super jelly.
And we watched fireworks at the National Monument, so that's not a bad 4th of July.
No, that's great!
Super fancy.
Yeah, exactly, I was about to say, I'll bet you the fireworks that they put off there are, like, super duper fancy.
Yeah. They haven't done much more than that recently, up until recently, is what I meant to say. Because I spent a couple of 4th of Julys with you.
Yeah, so my family lives, or used to live, I suppose my mom just moved, but we used to live just down the street from the University of Redlands in Redlands, California. And the University of Redlands would host an annual, like, super spectacular, like, professional-grade fireworks show. Really cool. And because we lived just down the street from the football stadium, we would go up onto our roof every 4th of July, and we would watch... Oh, so close. We would watch the fireworks from the top of our roof, sitting on our roof. other than that, it was just barbecue. We would make burgers and ribs and corn and baked potatoes, and we'd grub out all day long. For several years, as part of a church fundraiser, because again, my dad is a pastor, and so every holiday is riddled with church events, of course. So we would do a fundraiser that was, we would sell fireworks. We would rent out a fireworks booth, and then whatever we would sell that year would just go towards the church. So I spent several years in the middle of, you know, in late Jaloon. That is June and July combined. I'm just not even going to apologize. So I spent late / early Jaloon helping my dad sell fireworks. Or really, actually, because I was younger, I wasn't helping him sell. I was just hanging out by the fireworks booth like in a car, just chilling out. It was really fun, and we would come home because we had the fireworks booth. We would come home with all these really spectacular, you know, like home brand, the kind of stuff that you would see at a market, not like Roman candles or anything like that, just normal stuff. We would just all go to the church property that night, and there would be like a whole bunch of people lighting fireworks. So I got to light hundreds of fireworks as a kid. Speaking of things that go ahead.
Things that are super weird to me because those are illegal where I live.
Right.
So I was like, you can light fireworks in California? What is this even?
Yep. And still in Highland, I think you can light fireworks. Oh no. Oh. I totally messed that up. But yeah, so those are like a couple of the things that I would always do on the 4th of July. Would watch fireworks on the roof, and I would set fireworks off, depending on what year and where I was. Because, spending holidays with my mom is very different than spending holidays with my dad. Spending 4th of July with my dad is like a barbecue, and then we all sit around and watch a movie, which is great. I love watching movies. Never the same movie twice. We'd always pick something out that was like new and in theaters or all that kind of stuff. Oh, gosh. Oh, so New Year's. Tell us about your New Year's, Super Kaylin.
Kaylin.
Huh?
Super Kaylin.
That's you.
That's me.
I've got Alex still working on that artwork. I think he finally got a character that he liked. He just has to make it digital.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Nice. Well, I'm Japanese, for those of you who don't know.
Yes, I am a white guy who is marrying a very, very attractive, small Asian woman. Deal with your problems. Sorry.
Oh, face roll says you're in the background, by the way. Okay, the phone. And we do a Japanese New Year's type thing, which doesn't mean much like religiously to us. It's just more like Japanese, traditional Japanese food is how that goes.
Oh my goodness. And this spread was amazing.
The day before, on New Year's Eve, we'll go over to my boyfriend's house and like start preparing. Like the afternoon we just start cooking, and we would cook and cook and cook until the minute that the ball drops. And
it's when the truth.
When the ball drops, we have New Year's soba. We have like noodles.
Oh, it's right, so good too.
Right at midnight. Yeah, it's delicious and I love it. And then the next morning we have my favorite dish of all time. This is like my favorite food to eat. If you ever ask me like, what's your favorite food, Super Kaylin? It is this. And it's called Ozoni. So O-Z-O-N-I. Ozoni. Right? O-Z-O-N-I. Yeah.
Yes, and that is correct.
So bad it's spelled. Anyways. And it is, you know, mochi, like the dessert mochi. Like mochi ice cream.
Yeah.
The outer part that's like chewy and it's made of rice. Well, it can be prepared savory, and so they put it in a soup with like a little bit of veggies. And everybody does ozoni like from different parts of Japan. They do it differently.
Right.
It's kind of like, like pizza, I guess. Like where everybody has their own way that they like it. It has different things in it. Sometimes it's more simple. Ours is like more on the simple side. So we'll get up in the morning and have that. So it's like a very light soup. It's not like super crazy flavored or anything. It's actually flavored with like very lightly like with fish and like mushroom, which you liked it. So you like fish and mushrooms. Sorry to say, Kiwi.
It was enjoyable. I am not usually a big fan of strong flavors like fish and onions, or mushrooms rather. And mushrooms not a huge strong flavor, it's more of a texture thing. But especially like first thing in the morning, and that's like for breakfast, that you eat this for breakfast. But it was freaking tasty. It was freaking delicious.
Friggin'.
Well, what were you saying earlier that you said a whole bunch of times? Seriously. Seriously, guys. Seriously. I'm like, wow, you need to watch out. Like, you gotta plan your seriouslys more, sparsely. Seriously.
Anyway, so we'll have that. And then all the food that we prepared the night before, we'll have New Year's Day for dinner. And yes, that could be anywhere from, like, roast beef to, like, yellow diamonds, which I'm pretty sure is just a bunch of eggs that are put together. Like, little tiny fish eggs. Or raw oysters. Or, like, a bunch of, like, Japanese, like, vegetables that we kind of stewed in this really delicious sauce.
Oh, my goodness. Soy-based. Delicious.
Om nom nom.
Yes. Seriously, om nom nom.
And, yeah, that's kind of how my New Year's goes. We watch the ball drop and everything. And we watch... There's, like, a bunch of, like, Japanese television stuff that we'll watch. So they have, like, this annual show where all of the popular Japanese groups and some of the older, like, more traditional famous singers will all put on, it's like a giant concert, like, leading up till New Year's. Like, it'll start the day before or something. I don't know how long it is.
It's, you know what, we sat there and we watched it for probably a good 3 or 4 hours. It was long. They had, actually this year they had the lady who sang Let It Go. What's her name?
Idina Menzel.
That one. Yeah. They had her come on and they had her sing it on live television in Japan.
No, they I think they got a recording of her.
Yeah, like a recording of her singing it in a different country.
Yeah. Like, she recorded it for them so that way she didn't have to be there. You know what I mean?
Yeah, gotcha. Oh, goodness. No places to land! Oh, so frustrating.
So, that's cool. And
it's amazing. So, this spread of food, not only, like, it looks so cool. Just the amount of different shapes. It was really interesting to, like, try to eat. And I do say try to eat. Because there were some more questionable dishes.
As always.
Like, some that, you know, I'm kind of a big texture guy. If it doesn't have an appealing texture, I don't really enjoy eating it. Which means that there are a lot of foods that I don't eat, on a general kind of level. I almost made it. It made me feel better that there were, like, even some things on that platter that her grandma wouldn't eat. I was like, okay, so you make this every year and you won't even eat this. Like, oh, okay, that's all good. whoa. But, oh, it was like there were things that were crunchy, things that were spongy, things that were slimy, things that were chewy, things that tasted like the soy, you know, soy sauce, things that tasted like fish, things that tasted like things I can't describe. Things that didn't taste like anything. Oh man, then there was this. What's the chewy thing that tastes? It tasted like a fruit. It was like the sweet.
Oh.
Well, we had some red bean too, and that was super delicious.
I don't know. My mom will probably chime in and say it.
But like, I was told that was like for dessert, and I'm like, oh. Yeah. This is the only thing on this platter that I ate and wasn't like, well, that was strange.
Yeah.
Oh, bad. Man, we got her down to two bars. Oh, my soul.
Yokan is what it is.
Yokan. So good. It was so tasty. It was like The consistency was like, have you ever had those, they're not the fruit roll-ups, they're like the healthy version of fruit roll-ups.
Fruit leathers?
Yeah, fruit leathers. Oh god, those things were delicious. It's one of those weird things that I wished my parents had bought for me more often, but they just
never got
were.
Into those.
Yeah? I mean, they look funny, but they were, oh gosh, I loved those things. But anyways, it had the consistency of, like, fruit leathers.
It's a lot softer than fruit leather.
I mean, and a little bit thicker, too.
Whereas me is soft licorice.
But, like, you know, you sort of get the idea. It's a very different kind of texture.
Mm-hmm.
Welcome to the Super Cool Show. We talk about food a lot.
Healthy fruit roll-ups, Kappa.
Yeah, totally. They're like healthy fruit roll-ups. What? Was that your mom Kappa-ing me?
No, that was face roll. I'm glad that you automatically expect my mom to troll you, though.
Oh, I mean, what else are moms for? My mom trolls me constantly. Who? Lame. So, dude, Arrows Nation, how's that packing up of the gig clothes and jumping on Skype thing working out? You gonna? Oh, jeez Louise, bad, sad, bad. You gonna be joining us soon? I miss you. I want you to come be a part of my show. Oh, hey, look, the follower counter went up to 86. Apparently they left their follower. Their whatever. Jesus. I'm fighting a boss. It's hard, okay?
So hostile.
So what?
So hostile.
Don't judge me. It's hard. It's hard to run an entertaining show and play a game that's really difficult. Speaking of games that are really difficult, I think I know what game I'm going to be playing next. After we finish Wings of V, this will be kind of like the first unofficial slash official announcement of many. I'm sure that I'll be posting on Facebook and on Twitter the game that I intend to play next. But it's going to be the new King's Quest that just came out. I'm so excited about it. I love point-and-click adventures. This is a play on one of my favorite point-and-click adventures of, like, forever ago. Oh, oops. I forgot that I had things surrounding me. But I'm super excited to play it. And I watched like an episode or two of Game Grumps playing it, and it just looks so good. It's really pretty. It's like super chill. Like, it's puzzle solving, and it'll be a good like foil to this game, you know? So, anyways, I'm super excited about that. I hope that you are too. And if you're not, I'm sorry. Difficult games all the time makes Devin a weary traveler. So tell me, Kaylin, right around Hanukkah, how do you celebrate?
Right around Hanukkah?
Yeah, yeah. So what do you? So how do you celebrate Hanukkah?
Light up the menorahs. Celebrate.
And you sing dreidel, dreidel, dreidel?
Yeah. And wait for Santa to come.
And wait for Santa to come. The holiday armadillo. Wait for the holiday armadillo. Oh, gosh. You know what? This lady can go die. Seriously.
What do you do for Valentine's Day?
What did we do for Valentine's Day? What is it? 2 years ago now. 2 years ago? 1 year ago. Not this Valentine's Day, but the one before it.
We went on our first date.
Yeah. All right. What now, yeah. Suckers? And guess what? Now we're going to get married. Oh, whoa. I didn't see you. I think one more thing is in order before I hop on, gotta shower and get all pretty for you. Dude, your camera's not gonna be okay. He doesn't even have a camera. What is he worried about? Okay.
He just wants to shower.
That's okay. He can shower another time. I actually showered just for the show.
You should totally understand.
No. No understanding. It's not allowed. Whoa, how did that miss me? Holy crap. So what do we do for this last Valentine's Day? I don't even remember. Because I was, like, really short on cash this last Valentine's Day.
I think we went out for Thai food.
Is that it? Oh, man. I'm gonna have to spice up Valentine's Days from now on.
I don't remember.
What do you want to do for next Valentine's Day?
Go get Thai food.
That's a fairly good tradition. We do have the tradition of going out and trying Thai food places. Ow. Man, those blue fires just come and they tickle you, don't they? It's like,
Yeah, you were short on cash because you were buying me this pretty little thing that's on my left hand.
That little rock there? That little thing? I'm still paying for that. Yes, that's right. Because I sort of did tell you, I was like, yep, now that I got you this, pretty much happy birthday, happy Valentine's Day, Merry Christmas.
I was like, alright.
The most expensive gift I've ever purchased anyone. To say the very least. Oh, I thought I could get through it. Boo.
Boo. Oh no. A humbug.
Oh, what other... Jeez, there's gotta be at least one other holiday. One other holiday. It's coming up with holidays now. How do you spend Julismas? Oween.
Oh, I love me some Julismas.
Oween. Julismas Oween.
Oh, I thought you were just talking about straight Julismas.
No. Julismas Oween. It takes place in mid September.
Oh, it's coming up quick then.
Yeah, it's on September 21st. Yeah. Do you remember the 21st night of September? Yeah, Earth, Wind, and Fire made it famous, didn't you know?
Oh.
Their celebration of Julismas Ween is world-renowned for its amount of colors that you wear. It's the single most holiday where you wear the most colors.
Gotcha.
And you also have to mix and match patterns. But if you don't wear three or more colors, geez, I just keep going. If you don't mix up three or more colors, then it's not like St. Patrick's Day where they pinch you. They get to give you a semi-hard pat on your right shoulder specifically.
Oh.
Yes. And holy goodness gracious. And then basically the celebration of Julismas Oween is the celebration of our forefathers' ascension from India. It's basically, holy mackerel, I'm losing it, it's gone, that's it, I've lost my rhythm.
Nice job.
Good job. Ow, oh, I didn't even see. Gosh, darn it.
I wondered.
Ugh. How many times have we died to this boss already? Ugh. Did I tell you that I burnt my hand while I was cooking today?
No.
See that beautifulness? Oh, yeah. I was serving up my burrito for the night because I made burritos and there's so much leftovers.
How?
And yeah, so I was serving it up, and so I put my plate in like the center of the stove because there was no other spaces to put it. And just as I was filling up my burrito, my hand decided to, you know, tip ever so slightly, and I touched the burner that I had been cooking things on. Reheating things on, rather.
Oof.
Not fun. Wasn't the most enjoyable experience. Ran it under some cold water. It's not so sore now, unless I touch it against things accidentally. Ho! Ho! Ah. Oh. I dieted. What did you make burritos for? I beat the Shen in lane. Nice. Good job. Shens are really durable. I just made it as a meal because I like burritos. I live in Arizona and I miss my Mexican family, and so every so often I make a white man burrito. It's a little bit more like Chipotle burrito than like real like street taco style. Like I've got meats with spices that I can't pronounce because I'm white and that kind of stuff. It's like ground beef, a little bit of cumin, some red chili pepper, and rice that I get out of a package. But I just made it. I made it to eat, and there were just a lot of leftovers. Because I don't know how to cook for one person anymore, because Super Kaylin moved in with me for the summer, and I'm so used to cooking for two people now. What the? I didn't land on the thing. I'm sad. I've gotten into yo-yoing recently. That's awesome! And my right middle finger hurts when I rub it. I have no calluses. Dude, I have a friend who's super into yo-yoing. His name is Hunter. And he's amazing. I cannot believe the amount of coordination it takes to do some of those tricks. I'm just impressed. But then again, if you're someone who enjoys playing and speedrunning Wings of V, precision and muscle memory are not your weak suits.
True that. All right, drawing flowers, not my strong suit.
Really? Because I think the only thing that I'm good at drawing are roses. Dude,
I'm gonna come over and draw these for me then.
Girl, you got it. I will come over and draw you roses any day. Ow. And I have a fancy yo-yo coming in soon, but I'm still learning. Dude, everybody starts somewhere. That's like, you, and not everybody can be like the super talent like right away. But I've watched videos of people doing like single yo-yo and double yo-yo tricks, and I'm just like, oh my gosh, you guys are awesome. I used to yo-yo as a kid, but it was like up and down, and I could do what we would call the barrel roll, where you just flip it over your wrist. But that stuff is like child's play. Gosh darn it, I was gonna hit you in the face, and then you did this annoying thing that you do every so often that's just a part of your bossiness. Cause I'm bossy!
Dude, I can't even yo-yo. Can't get it to do anything.
Really?
Yeah. I haven't tried super hard. I'm really bad at picking up hobbies. Just not a hobby person.
Not a hobby person?
Yeah. I know that seems really weird, but just I.
No! Ah, gosh darn it. Man, I was doing really well. I had lots of health.
I think I was, like, really afraid of being, like, super distracted.
Yeah.
From things that I have to do, like school.
Yeah. Ugh. Yeah, it's kind of, like, it's weird. Especially when you're specializing in something like music, which requires a ton of practice time. Because, like, I like to play guitar, and I like to sing, and, I mean, I practice singing all the time because I sing to my radio in the car, but, like, It's strange to try to balance all of the various things in life. Wow, that was the worst opening. Hard to balance all the things in life you want to do. But it's certainly worth it to keep up a couple of different hobbies that aren't your main, you know, doodly-doo. One of my biggest hobbies is playing video games, which is why I actually have this show. This is a hobby to me. I saw FaceRoll post about an X-Brain. I just glanced over really quick.
Single looping, two yo-yos, double yo-yos, string tricks, off-string, and a counterweight. I got a cool Yomega X-Brain from my friend yesterday.
Dude, I had an X-Brain when I was a kid. I had a blue X-Brain. It was the bomb. My best friend had a red one. And that nonsense was the best.
He said, there's the five A's, well, the five different styles of yo-yoing. And that was single looping, two yo-yos, double yo-yos, string tricks, parentheses, string tricks, off-string, and a counterweight.
Huh.
Learn something new every day.
What are you laughing at me for? So I make noises when I'm evading attacks. Okay. Okay.
You have a wide variety of noise-making sounds. Noise-making abilities.
Oh, the worst. The worst. I'm the worst at video games. Oh, you know what? It is time to take another break. So you stick right there. I think we've got one more part for tonight, and we're going to be calling it an evening because I have to get up early tomorrow for class. Ew. We'll be right back with some more Wings of V. Burb.